Today we can go to the third lesson of fourth module, that is Hagar, a story of woman and water. And as you go through the title, you can understand the story is about two things, that is about a woman and water. It is written by Sarah Joseph. When you go to page number 126, you can see something about the author. And as you can see in the first paragraph, Sarah Joseph is a leading feminist writer in Malayalam. And also, she is the founder of Manushi, an organization for women thinkers. And the rest of it, you can read and understand. And then, when we come to the second paragraph about the author, we can see something about the lesson. Then you will get an idea about what is the theme of Hagar, a story. And you can turn your pages to the second paragraph. There you can see it is taken from a novel called The Gift in Me, which is written by Sarah Joseph. And this is the second chapter of The Gift in Me. And the main theme is given there in the second line. And that is water as the fundamental giver and the preserver of life. So water is described as an elixir of life. So you might have heard about the word elixir. Elixir means something which gives life to us. So in the Puranas, there is a reference about elixir. And people went in search of elixir in order to be immortal, to keep them alive. And so here water is also described as such an elixir of life. So it is a preserver of life. That you can see through the lesson. And also, as you can go through the third line of the paragraph, it is already given there, but a description is given. Actually, the story, Hagar and Ishmael, and that was a very common story existing among a community called Adi, that is already given there. And now Sarah Joseph has added some biblical reference to this story and has written her story, Hagar's story. And then a long description about the lesson is already given. There is a reference about Abraham, and Abraham has already given up Hagar and Ishmael. And also later a mysterious bird appeared, and that bird actually saved Hagar and Ishmael from a desert. And that you can see, because you know a desert is having no greenery at all, there is no water at all. But when the mysterious bird appeared, a spring was found out by Hagar, and that became a preserver of life for Hagar and Ishmael later. And then you can see Hagar understood what is the importance of water, and then she became the owner of that spring. And in relation with that spring, some tribal people came there, and also some nomads are coming there. And now there was a water covenant made in between Hagar and these nomads and tribes. And then about a covenant is also given. Covenant means a treaty made between two people. That is what is given here. And also you can see another theme. The second theme is given towards the end of that paragraph. And that is about a woman's endurance and boundless generosity. So Hagar as a woman, and she was having endurance. Endurance means the power to suffer something or tolerance like that. And also she was very generous. That means when the nomads and tribes came there, and they were also given water by this Hagar. And so she was generous, her generosity was there. And also, as you can see towards the end of the paragraph, it is given, the novel was inspired by the myths and ethos of the island municipality of Palanakkad in Kerala. So, altogether we can see Hagar, a story of woman and water. And it is a mixture of biblical reference, and also so many myths existed in one village in Kerala. And also there is a particular story existing among a community called Adi. So these three are mixed together when Sarah Joseph has written this particular lesson. And in order to get an idea about Hagar, you can come to the end of the lesson. and there you can see something about who this father is, and only you can understand what is the endurance of father abroad. And when you come to page number 133, towards the end of the lesson, and there is a note is given about the father, and there you have seen this father is a biblical character, and you can see this character in the Old Testament of the Bible. And actually this father was the servant or maid of Abraham's wife Sarah, and later after so many years of married life, Sarah and Abraham were childless, no child was born to them. So Sarah gave this Hagar, that is the servant of her, as a wife of Abraham, and in that relationship a child was born to Abraham, and that child is Ishmael. But later, due to some reason, and there was a problem between Sarah and Hagar, because after so many years, when Sarah became very old, Sarah became pregnant, and she also gave birth to a child, and that is Ishmael, Isaac. And there, in between Hagar and Sarah, a particular problem arose, and as a result, Abraham had to give up his wife, that is Hagar and Ishmael. Both of them were abandoned in the desert. And so as you can go through the last portion of that paragraph, you can see the Muslims are supposed to be the descendants of this Ishmael. And so this Muslim community, they gave so much respect to Ishmael's mother, Hagar. And so you might have got an idea about who this Hagar is. And Hagar is Abraham's second wife. She was the second wife of Abraham. Actually, she was the maid of Sarah, but later she became the wife of Abraham. But due to some reason, Abraham had to give up both of them, Ishmael and Hagar, in the desert. And based on this biblical story, this Sarah Joseph had written the story, Hagar, the story of Abraham. So you can come to the lesson. And so here, when you come to the introduction of the lesson, can get an idea about it. And so now it is starting. Now at a very early morning, the first paragraph is talking about that. The early morning, Abraham, and now he wake up Hagar and Ishmael from their sleep, and it was a very early morning. And now three of them, Hagar, Ishmael and Abraham, they started a journey. While they were starting their journey, before that, Abraham had already stored some loaves of bread, some pieces of bread, and also some dates for his mother and son. And also Abraham collected one goat skin full of water. And these three things Abraham had already prepared in order to give to Hagar and Ishmael when they were given up in the desert. And now you can see both this Hagar, Ishmael and Abraham, they are going to a desert. And when you come to the second paragraph, there you have seen Abraham made Hagar and Ishmael to come down from the camel. And now there is a reference is given about the desert, and that you can underline, and that is a wilderness where the mountains were bare, bare means empty, and the landscape bore thorns and thistles. So thorny bushes are there in that desert. So in such a thorny desert, and which was filled with the bushes, especially thorny bushes, and also mountains were there, but these mountains were empty mountains. So altogether, this desert is very empty, and there is nobody there. That is why it is called the wilderness. Wilderness here refer to that the only desert where Abraham gave up his wife Hagar and also his son Ishmael forever. And now after leaving the mother and the son in the desert, Abraham started his return journey. And then what all feelings Hagar had when Abraham gave up both of them, and that is given in the coming lines. And she is asking so many questions to Abraham. But Ram is not giving any answer to Agha's question. He is not stopping his journey at all. He is continuing his journey.